Okay, what happened with this video is a year and a half ago I recorded this. It was very, very hot, and on this day I overheated, and I suffered some internal and maybe brain damage temporarily. It was too hot to work. I should have done a smaller section. However, here I'm explaining that the stone wall there, the stone bricks, is resting on fairly good foundation. However, there is a course of loose rubble in between that. So in the past, that section there did crack. And what I did was I dug way down on top, you can't see it, but on top of the landing there, and poured cement into it, so that's now secure. You can see that in the past, around about in the 1970s, they put that sandstone there. They formed those sandstone bricks and built a wall. If you fast forward 10 minutes, you'll come to the sound. But what happened here is the sound didn't turn out, and so I'm sitting here now just explaining. I don't throw out video, so it's just kept as so you can see here, the right at the bottom there's a good foundation stone, fairly good foundation stones above it, but through the middle there there's a course of loose rubble, and you can see roots growing through it, and that won't hold the stonework above it. And that's a fairly important wall there, because it's the entire side path up around to the back door. But that big boulder there I'm keeping, and at this point in time the work's not finished, but that big boulder there in this shot at the front of it, I'm keeping that. That's a good foundation. However, in front of that there's the stones that I'll have to remove, so that's a back away from the angle, the edge. That's working forward, and there you can see that loose course of stone there. And there's a good rock above it, supporting it. There's a lot of weight up there, you know. So I have to do something about this now, and I'm part of the way through at this point in time. But that small rock in front there, in front of the crack, that's got to be removed, and anything there that you see there to the right hand side. So at the moment, that big rock there that I'm pointing at behind that crack there, that one there, that's supported at this point in time. So I think I've said most of it, but what I will say is that using lime in the sand and cement is the key to this sort of work. You can't just mix up sand and cement, because it will slump. Okay, it'll fall down. And I think that lime's got a fairly good ability to prevent water absorption, and it has a strengthening effect. As much as it's got good plasticity with the lime in it. So that is to say, you know, if you form a hill, say, like pottery, with lime in the sand and cement, it'll stay there, it won't just slump. So what I've done here is, with a jackhammer, I've just removed that loose rubble through there, and I've gone in about 100 millimetres, and I'm filling that with sand and cement. I'm getting better as I go. And using the lime has been a really good move. So I think here I'm just saying that I'll do it in sections. That's a good idea. However, the first section where I actually build a plaster sheet support mold, where I can sort of get my fingers in above it. It didn't work out too well. There was no need for it. I should have just mixed lime in with the sand and cement. But I'm just pointing out here that that shot back there, that's a small creeper, and I did say that I'd probably have to remove that, and that was removed yesterday. So that now there's no roots. I mean, there'll be roots from that tree probably mulling around and growing around there, but you want to, you know, when it comes to trees and that type of thing, they will destroy things like cement slabs and foundation rock, such as we're seeing here. That's work that I've done in the past. There is a video on that, and I've just put sand and cement, like a ledge, a flat level ledge on it, to protect the stone underneath from weathering away, and also to make a workable flat surface that you can work on. Okay, so here it looks like I've removed some rubble. I've gone in a little bit. Probably first attempts, you know, when you come in to start a job, you usually, unless you're a professional and that's your line of work, you usually work to extremities, like your tools and system and design may be insufficient, and so you go with bigger, more powerful tools and you're able to get it done. But you start off small and work to big. Yeah, so there is some cracking there. It's probably like that before they put the path around to the back of the house. The sand and cement in that stone wall isn't really strong enough. They didn't put enough cement in with the sand. Yeah, so here it looks like I've probably done a bit more work. That's a little bit of earth coming through. In between the rock surfaces there, there's earth movement. You know, up around Sydney, there's a lot of sandstone rock on top of bedrock. So if you look at a hill that's been excavated or mined, There's a large amount of pure sandstone, and then you've got like rocks, and then earth and rocks and stones, and the stones become smaller as you get up to the top of the on top of the soil or stone. So further down you go here, the less earth and the more pure sandstone. So there it looks like I had the jackhammer out. There was a quick shot of that. And here it's probably the work's done, the initial work to expose, to get rid of the rubble and earth and expose a surface I can work with and fill it in with cement just to support that rock above. I mean, we don't know how far that rock comes out. Could go back a long way, but I don't think so. I think that's the original stone face, and then they've put in they've got rid of anything forward of that because there's a garage behind us. So here we are, and that's just about ready for sand and cement. You see there are different courses, different layers, with earth in between, that the rocks slowly move along. So this is where I went wrong. See, not having used lime recently, or not having used it, I was thinking about getting lime, but I thought I'd just go with the materials I had. I wanted to make a good start on that day. And what happened on this day was, as I mixed up sand and cement, as I say later on in the video, the temperature shot up about 15 degrees and I just got hammered in the middle of working with materials that were curing and going hard. So it's just bad luck. I could have looked at the weather forecast, but that's not really reliable, so. However.
Okay, well, it's nearly 4 o'clock, and it was extremely hot during the middle of the day, and I was able to rest, but only after mixing up quite a substantial amount, quite a lot of cement. I've got a feeling that a lot of it's probably fallen down behind the plaster sheet barrier there. The last video didn't work out. I think that was a video of me putting the cement in to fill the hole. So, well, anyway, we'll carry on and you can see here, looks like a fair amount has fallen down. So it's time to take away the plaster sheet and see what I've got, so I'll do that now. At this stage, I'd just like to say that in a situation like this, you do have to be careful that as it goes hard, that you're pushing the cement up and in to fill the hole. Sometimes if you get something and press hard against it, it'll give and there'll be a hole there somewhere, if you haven't worked it up underneath into the gap. Okay, well, first impressions is it's not too bad, so let's see. Okay, that work was, and I've still got one section, two sections, so from there to there was 1.5 bags of cement and 4.5 bags of sand.